everybody, this is Vic from Vic's Creative Corner. So today we're going to talk about Wavelink and Stream Deck on macOS. I'm going to be setting up Discord while we're doing this, but first let's get into Wavelink. So a lot of you are wondering, how do I set up my VSTs? If you've installed your VSTs, and there is an array of them here on Apple that you can actually use. The only one that I cannot successfully install is a noise suppressor. But these are all the VSTs that are on Elgato's website. And then on top of that, some of them are from Defrag's suggestions on video as well. So I'll post a link to Defrag's video for macOS. And you'll be able to see that here after this ad. This is also on Elgato's website. And this is going to be the recommendation for all of the VSTs that will be working with Mac, with the exception of the noise suppressor. I can tell you the noise suppression right here are in noise and voice effects, because they are going to be based off of this one's NVIDIA. NVIDIA is not compatible with Mac. The RNN Noise just doesn't have a macOS platform. It has Linux and it has Windows. So these will not work on Mac. Just throwing it out there. I tried. It's not going to work. But this is going to be available for Mac for everything else, with the exception of the noise suppression that Elgato recommends. I can do that later. Sorry, I'm getting sidetracked here. It's been a while since I've been able to do a Mac video. I'm kind of excited. Alrighty. So we're going to talk about game launchers, right? So I showed you on Windows how to set up your Stream Deck to be a game launcher. And yes, Steam does not have that many macOS games. And honestly, I don't play in macOS. I only play in Windows. But I downloaded these for the sake of the video, right? So you see what I'm doing. I'm just dragging and dropping. When you download and install them, they're basically kind of already in a wrapper from Steam. Some of them have the icons, some of them don't. In this case, we could technically change the icon if we wanted to. At this point, I don't see the point in changing it just for right now. I mean, if I really wanted to game on the Mac, I could go into the extent of looking at the package contents, looking for the icons, and then copying and pasting them to my desktop and then installing them as an icon and uploading it here on the Stream Deck. I've already done that all with Windows. I don't game on the Mac, and I learned a hard lesson on that reason why with an external GPU. I use the Mac mainly for editing purposes, and that includes photography. So with that, let's go ahead and launch up the game. Oh, it pulled up on my other monitor. I'll drag that over here. So you can see Tunic was just recently released. And it is available on macOS for those who want to play this adorable little game. It is very much like Zelda. Anyways, we're going to go ahead and quit. But if you notice, the noise didn't come through here, right? Oh, you know what? I should have kept it open. That way I could show you how to set up sound. Right, so here we go, right? Well, we want to add an audio input. So with Elgato, they give us the option to add 9 inputs. That also is extended to the Mac. So if you want your game audio to come through, for example, you should see the bars at the top in the game. And that's how you're going to be able to control the game. There are some macOS games that do not work this way and that will automatically go to a system default. And there's no way to control those at this time, which includes Minecraft. I know there are some people who do play Minecraft on the macOS. Minecraft is one of those games that it will not work with Wavelink at this time on macOS. But there are some games that do. And I showed you just how to set up a game audio. So you're able to control it here. And if you see it, it's going to show up here. Now, when you get out of the window, clearly it's going to stop. It's like pausing the game. But if you go back into it, you're able to see the bars move at the top here. And if you have control over your audio, you can actually lower it. And you're going to see that adjusts. So that's how you're going to set up sound for a video game if you're playing it on macOS. I'm going to close this out. We don't need it. Now we're going to go ahead and do the same thing with Stardew Valley. Stardew Valley, I wouldn't mind playing on the macOS, you know, just while I'm passing time editing if I needed to take my mind off of what I was doing. But I don't like distractions when I'm editing because every pixel counts when you're actually in there doing certain things with color corrections, etc. So it's a lot of fun photography for me. It's one of those things where, you know, you just got to give it some time. All right. So as we see, we don't see Stardew Valley here. But we do see Stardew Valley right here. This is kind of like one of those caution signs here. Sometimes this is going to happen in Wavelink. It's just letting you know something's going on. Unfortunately, in this case, it's just that it's in a wrapper from Steam, so it's still going to function like normal audio. And as you can see, I'm bringing the audio even lower. So this is how you're able to see that it works. The reason why I chose Stardew Valley is because even though I move it to a different window, I know the audio will still play. So I can show you an example of how the audio works from high to low on the volume. But this is how you would set up a game launcher here in Stream Deck. And this is how you would set up for the audio for your game. And actually, you can do this not just with games, but with applications as well. So if you were doing, for example, Final Cut Pro, or if you were doing Logic Pro, you would be setting them up the same way. And in this case, you know what? Let's go ahead and launch one of them. It might take a bit of resources from my computer. Let's go ahead and launch. Yeah, let's launch Final Cut Pro. That way I can show you what I'm talking about here. If I wanted to control the audio, it's not fully loaded yet. Give it just a minute. Oh, it's still saved on my video from when I was doing the face cam unboxing. Yeah, I enjoy photography. It's one of my favorite things to do. But now that I have Final Cut open, and I could actually just lower the volume while I'm working in it if I wanted to. Like I said, it works with applications, and it works with game apps if you're doing something as far as a game. So the same thing works when you're wanting to do like a shortcut. So here's my applications folder. This is the only way it's going to work as far as like an app launcher. I just tapped it on my Stream Deck and Final Cut is going to pop open. So I'm going to close this out, right? Because I don't need Final Cut Pro open right now, but I'm going to launch it. And it's going to pop open. And it's going to go to the last saved place that I had it. So you just saw it relaunch. And it works with any of these applications. But keep in mind, Elgato only gives you 9 inputs. So you'll probably get used to maybe switching them in and out. Like, I will probably remove this input because I don't play games on my Mac. But I would probably add... Let's see. I don't really do any audio in Affinity Photo. But iMovie, yeah, I do use iMovie. So I could basically set up iMovie right here. So I'm showing you right now, like real time, the audio and the app launching, not just for game launching. A lot of people think that the Stream Deck is mainly for people who are doing streams. Aww, my old setup before it changed. Okay, we're taking a little trip down memory lane for a moment. But you see how iMovie is now here. If I wanted to adjust anything in iMovie... Okay, we'll do this. Hopefully I'm not super loud in my video here. Oh yeah, we're talking about the Xbox Series X and how to make it 120 hertz, etc. So that's pretty cool. But you see how you can control the audio, right? It's not just with the game. It's with applications as well. And you could technically do the same thing with Logic. You could do it with a whole bunch of different apps. But, you know, we're not going to make a long, long video about this. I just wanted to show you the basics. Honestly, once you first get the Elgato, if you click here, this is pretty cool when you get a Stream Deck. I clicked on the button. Oh, I meant I have to tap the button physically. Oops. Oh, it's been a day, y'all. Okay. So it takes you here. Everything, setting up, customization for first-time users. So, like, if you accidentally delete that little button, it's okay. You can always come to Elgato, go to Stream Deck, and then they just talk about it. It takes you directly to their page. But yeah, there's a lot of tutorials, a lot of videos out there on how to do so many functions with Elgato's Stream Deck. And then there's quite a few that Elgato has made for Mac and Windows. They have step-by-step guides as well. So if you're into reading, I am. I like reading, and then I like to implement them in my videos. It makes it so much easier if you're trying to look for something. You know, they're very resourceful. And if anything, if you're stuck on something, you can call customer support. You can even open up a support ticket and they'll get back to you. Trust me, they will. I've also been on the end where I've had to reach out to support quite a few times, and they're a wonderful customer service team. But that's going to be what we're going to talk about with Wavelink. That's going to be what we're talking about with Stream Deck tonight, is just basically showing you how to set them up for an app launcher, showing you how to set up the audio. So I hope this was very easy for you. All right, everybody, I totally forgot one last thing. It was the Discord for Mac. I had to install it. It took a minute. Oh, we only see the ones by Krabs. Aw. You know what? His member count is pretty cool. It lets you know how many people are on your Discord at one time. But we need to go to... Here's the Discord officially by Elgato, because this is the one that everybody has been using and apparently are having trouble with on Macs. So I want to test this out real time with y'all. Okay, it says it's installed. La-di-da. Okay, here we go. So there's mute. There's deafen. There's a voice channel. You know what? I'm going to set this up for my comms, but I'm going to request access. Oh, hold on. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to drag my Discord over here so you all can see it. Alrighty. Alright, so we're going to request access. And it's saying authorize, right? So it tells you all the Discords that you're in. So we're going to go to mine. Where's mine? Mine should be at the bottom. Here we go. And I'm going to go ahead and select my comms. Now, when I push the button, it's connecting me. As you can see, I'm connected to my comms. And now I'm disconnected from my comms. I'm not seeing the issue that everybody else seems to be having. This one is a text channel, so same concept. You would just go here. Yeah, we're not going to my audits. Nope, we're not doing that. Not on stream. Not on videos. But we're going to go to my general. We're already there. And I won't set up the friends channel. It's a private channel. It's for people I know in person and have met in my lifetime. But we can maybe set it up for another text channel that I like to visit. Let's go to Elgato's. Now, I like going to their general because I actually hang out with them. Say hello, do some fun stuff. It takes me there. I also help out with their community help. And it's going to go here, and we're going to go here. So I'm setting this up real time, showing you how it works. If you have an authorized Discord in your settings on Mac, I suggest you do so, because if not, you won't be able to use the request access feature properly. I might have to change that. Accessibility. You know what? We probably should change that real quick here. One thing I love about Apple is it blocks out my passwords, so y'all can't see them. There's one that comes in the moment that you sign up. It asks you to authorize it here somewhere. I'm looking for it. No, that's not it. This one, input monitoring, accessibility, speech. You definitely want to do that so that way you can use a microphone in Discord. I ran across that issue, but I set it up pretty quickly. You can disable and if you don't want it in location services to track it. Honestly, I don't care because I'm rarely on the Mac. And I use a VPN like I said, 90% of the time. So, you know, for the sake and purpose of the video, it says I'm in Dallas, but I'm actually in a different city. All right. But I am in Texas. So the next one we can do is we can channel hop, right? So I go and I hang out with the VBI guys, Visual by Impulse. So what I do is I go here to their general, but I also hang out with their affiliate. I'm like, don't worry, there's a reason for this. I'm showing you all because I know you all have been having trouble setting this up, and I have not. So maybe if you follow the video, this might help you. So that way you're able to get yours functioning correctly. But I go and say hi there. I go and hang out in the affiliate hangout because I am a VBI affiliate, and there is a link on my Twitch in the About Me, and very soon you'll be seeing a code pop up on my videos very shortly with the super tools that they make. They're so awesome. They really are. The community between Elgato, Corsair, and VBI, they're wonderful. So speaking of Corsair, right? So let's go over here. I don't go to their bot commands. Which one is the one I go to? Casual. I go here. This is my favorite place. And I remember when I was struggling to upgrade the cooler in my PC, I went to another channel. And everybody here, you know, it's all community. It's all people just like you and me. And they're all very, very kind and fun people to be around. Here we go. Where is it? Consoles and Tech. Unofficial Tech Help. This is a place to go if you need help with any of your PC building. There's a lot of people who will help you. And, you know, sometimes they have game nights, too. It's pretty cool. It is pretty cool. But Discord is working. If I wanted to deafen, you could see the little headphones have the slash in the bottom. If I wanted to unmute, I could unmute myself. So it's working. It's fully functional. Just make sure that you have your security allowed so that way you're able to use your Discord functions with the Elgato Discord app. Anybody have any issues with it, make sure that you check there first. Make sure you check your settings. And then go and request access, and it should be working smooth sailing. Anyways, I wanted to thank you all for watching the video for the macOS version of using some Elgato products, such as the Stream Deck, making it work with Discord. Also, the Wavelink. Thank you for your time, and you all have a lovely evening. I hope to see you next video.